Hello guys, welcome to our channel. I'm Aniket Agarwal and today I will be teaching you how can you convert the M2TS files into MKV. So we all know that M2TS files are those files that are on the Blu-ray disc. So when you, if you buy a Blu-ray disc and put it on your computer, you will see that the files that are there are M2TS. So I have downloaded some samples of M2TS file to show you how can we convert them into MKV. See, all the three files are M2TS files and we will be converting into MKV files without any quality loss. So this will be totally lossless quality. No re-encoding will be done as in the case of Handbrake. Many tutorials show you that you can use Handbrake to convert them, but that turns down the quality of the videos. But in this method, it will be Remux. So in Remux, only the container is changed. So M2TS will be changed to MKV, but the quality and size, everything will remain intact. So what you need to do is you want to download a free software that is MKV Toolex. So I will be putting the link of this site in the description and you can choose whether your computer is 64 bit or 32 bit and accordingly you can download the file. You can also download the portable versions if you are on if you are comfortable with the portable version instead of installing the whole software. And if you are on Mac, you can use this macOS version, and on Linux image is also given there. So after downloading the appropriate one, you need to install it. You all know how to install the program. Just click on next, next, next and everything will be done. So I have already downloaded it, so I won't be downloading it again. So this is how it looks. So this is the front page of MKV Toolex GUI. This is version 55.000, 64-bit. You can use any version, doesn't matter. We don't have to change anything in here. Now we will go to our folder. We will take the file and drag it to this thing. It will show the tracks on the file, like this is the video file and this is the audio file. If there is some kind of subtitle, it will also be there. If there are tracks other than English language, so this is the language, like French, German, Japanese, it will also show those files. You can uncheck the file if you don't want. So if I don't want this English audio, I can uncheck it, and after converting into MKV, this audio will not be included and the size variation will only be because of this audio file. Video will not be compressed at all, video will not be encoded at all. So I want this track, so it will remain as it is, and then we don't have to change any settings in output or attachments. The destination file will automatically be taken as the same folder in which the original file was there, and it is automatically showing here mkv.mkv. Now you just need to click on start multiplexing. It will take a few seconds, and after a few seconds a new file will be created in the same folder, this one, and this says MKV. So this is the MKV file that has been created from that M2TS file. So this was a 39.6 MB file, and this MKV file is a bit less, but the quality loss is not there. So it is the same quality as this because we have not re-encoded the file. We have just changed the container of the file. So this process is called remuxing of the files. So that way you can remux any of your Blu-ray rips into MKV containers and then play it along your, you know, Plex server or anywhere else, because it won't be a difficult thing for any media player or any device to play. But M2TS files cannot be natively played, and even if you are using Plex or MB as a media server, it will also keep on transcoding those files, and because of transcoding, a lot of CPU power is used and quality also suffers. So this can be avoided by changing the M2TS file into a MKV file. So we'll again try with another sample. So just close this right now and now click on the new file. Okay, this time we'll try the Ultra HD version. So this is a UHD 4K clip. So this has only the video, so it is showing only the video file. Click on start multiplexing and it is done. So this was 24 MB, this is 21 MB. This is just a container change, size changes because just of the container and nothing else. The quality is intact. So like if this is the 4K version of M2TS file, this was the M2TS file. This is the same exact version just in the MKV container. So we can even successfully convert the 4K or Ultra HD files or Ultra HD Blu-ray files from M2TS to MKV without any quality loss, totally lossless, no compression at all, and without re-encoding anything. So this was it for this tutorial. I hope this tutorial helped many of you guys, and if this did help you, kindly consider buying me a coffee by clicking on the join button below the subscribe button. Thank you for watching this video. Have a nice day.